Going to measure the resistance now of the protective bonding conductor, the conductor that goes from the consumer unit or the main earth terminal and goes off to feed the gas pipe, water pipe, oil pipe. And in this case, for a domestic property, we're looking at the conductor being 10 millimetres squared as the smallest size. Going out, in this case, we're trying to simulate two pipes, one being water and one being gas. Before the protective bonding conductor can be removed from the consumer unit, we must ensure the consumer unit is isolated and turned off. Main double pole switch in this case is off. Okay. In the event of us disconnecting the conductor with the consumer unit live, you could find that simultaneously the metalwork becomes live, and obviously the person doing the test or customer could receive a shock that could be fatal. So distribution board needs to be off before the test is carried out. We're using our long 50 meter lead this time, as we would in an installation, which we removed the resistance of it earlier, as stated in a previous video clip on how to remove the resistance of leads. Exactly the same technique for removing it this time, it's just 50 meters in length. The likelihood of getting a reading of any value will be remote, because the length of the cable in our installation is very short. We know from previous discussions that in a domestic property, the 10 millimeter squared cable cannot exceed 27 meters in length before it needs to be moved up to the next size. We've got a 10 millimeter squared protective bonding conductor. We're going to test it's connected to a simulated gas and water pipe, and we're going to prove the reading doesn't exceed 0.05 ohms. The likelihood is we're going to get next to nothing. Okay, so we go on to the front of the clamp to start with on pipe one. Our reading is unfortunately dead zero, which is, we know, impossible to have a resistive free cable, but we've got it as zero this time. But the important is the clamp makes the pipe. We're more interested to get to the back pipe, and our reading again is next to nothing, it's zero. We go to the second pipe, we check the front of the clamp, and we get a reading of 0.03, but we're more concerned about the reading at the back on actually onto the pipe itself. Again, our reading is zero. Of all the readings we get, we record the highest one, in this case 0.03, which is under the maximum reading of 0.05. Therefore, the protective bonding conductor complies and can be left in installation.